Hello guys, welcome to the video. This is top 5 emo songs in my opinion, part 2. Alright, so first up for number 5, we have Voices by Sowsen. One interesting fact about Voices is that it was originally written and recorded by Sowsen's former lead vocalist, Anthony Green. When Anthony Green left the band in 2004, he took the song with him and re-recorded it with his new band, Circa Survive. Sowsen eventually re-recorded the song with their new lead vocalist and released it on their debut album. Overall, Voices is a fantastic example of Sowsen's signature sound. If you haven't checked out the band before, I highly recommend giving them a listen. Next up, for number 4, we have Understanding in a Car Crash by Thursday. Now I know, Thursday is a very interesting band name, like the name of a week and a day. I think I got that mixed up. Understanding in a Car Crash is one of Thursday's most popular songs. It was released in 2001 on their album Full Collapse. The title of the song comes from a line in the book Less Than Zero by Bret Easton Ellis. The lyrics about a car crash that the lead singer Geoff Rickley was in when he was younger. The crash left him with physical and emotional scars, and the song explores the aftermath of the experience. Number 3, Baby You Wouldn't Last a Minute on This Creek by Chiodos. The lyrics are about a toxic relationship and the feeling of being trapped in a cycle of love and pain. One interesting fact about Baby Wouldn't Last a Minute on This Creek is that it was produced by Casey Bates, who also worked on bands like Portugal, The Man, and Pierce the Veil, which is very popular now, and everyone knows Pierce the Veil, unless Pierce the Veil. Let's just stop, drop everything, forget each other's names, and just walk away. The song's title is actually a reference to the scene in the movie Deliverance, 1972, in which one of the characters says to another, "You ain't gonna make it down that river, my friend, not with them pearly white city boy shoes. You ain't got no grip." The phrase "you wouldn't last a minute on this creek" is a variation of that line, and has since become a popular saying among fans of the song and the band. And up next, for number 2, we have Ocean Avenue by Yellow Card, which was popularized by Emo's Not Dead. There's a place off Ocean Avenue, where I used to sit and talk with you. We were both 16 and it felt so right, sleeping all day, staying up all night. Believe it or not, they didn't believe that the name Ocean Avenue was a good album cover name. Despite its widespread popularity and success, the song almost didn't make it into the album of the same name. The band's record label initially didn't believe that Ocean Avenue was a strong enough single and wanted the band to release a different song instead. However, the band members strongly believed in the song and plotted to have it included on the album. Their persistence paid off as Ocean Avenue went on to become Yellow Card's most successful single and helped propel the album to platinum status. Get ready for number 1. You wouldn't believe it at all. Alright guys, it is Kings and Queens by 30 Seconds to Mars. Woo! Empty fans have found dreams.
looks like it hurts.
The song's lyrics are about seizing the moment and living to the fullest, even in the face of uncertainty and adversity. The video was filmed in Los Angeles and features hundreds of people on bicycles, skateboards, and roller skates, all dressed in sorts of types of clothing and wearing illuminated helmets. The video is a stunning visual spectacle and perfectly captures the song's message of unity and empowerment. Alright guys, well, that's the video. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully stay tuned, and yeah, the list is in no particular order, or maybe it is. I think it is in a particular order. Yeah, I lied. But thank you for watching the video. Hopefully like and subscribe, but you don't have to. See you soon.